So here's a bit of a history. I started in 2015. I worked with Matty Jarvis for 2 years. Then I worked with Sean, who was running Yeti Scaffold at the time. And I've also worked with Sam Rebay from DJS All Guns. You know, that I go on about, you know, the scaffolding job in the industry a lot. But yeah, it's taken me a lot of hard work to get here, you know, like, I was a, you know, labourer for like 4 years, you know, and I've been a boss for 2 years now. So that gives you an indication of everyone to the far north of G-Town and on the East Coast. You obviously know what I'm doing now, you know, I'm scaffolding. But, you know, it's a really good motivational thing for me to do, you know, to get some of the regionals back home into doing it, you know. The boys that were coming in, you know, I taught them how to do it cleanly and properly, I gave them ways of showing them, you know, easier ways of doing it. Like 10, 15 guys at one stage, you know, when I first year I started, it was very difficult, you know, like just to try and keep track, because sometimes we'll be getting 5, 7, 8 jobs a day, you know, and that's the mental pressure that you have every day, you know. You know, what I've learnt over the last 2 years is that, you know, you can't be too kind and generous, you know, to, you know, your workers. You know, you help them out, bro, and then fucking, you know, you become too kind and friendly. You can't be friends with your workers, bro, you can't. To me, bro, the slowest guy is not a defect at all, bro, it's not. Bro, Jay started out like that, bro, and he ended up getting really good at it, bro. You know why? Because he pushed himself, bro. He kept pushing himself, and that's how you do it, bro. Issues. I like to be realistic about things. You know, one other thing too is employers, bro, should not discuss wages between other employers, bro, because it causes conflict and it can cause everything to go pear-shaped, bro. You know, it fucks things up. But, you know, bro, money and hourly wages should not be discussed between employees. If there's a problem, bro, with wages, you talk to the boss about it, bro. You don't go telling anybody. You keep that to yourself, bro. That's the code of scaffolding, bro. I've always heard that and know that. So of why, you know, I've always had to shut ship, bro, because I've never backcharged for any of the fucking countless costs on the job. You know, I've given out loads, bro, to people that I shouldn't have, bro, and, you know, it's just, like, that's what I mean, bro, it's a good, having a good heart, bro. You know, I have one more question. You fellas probably thought that, you know, I've got this handed to me how I started the business. Actually, I worked 2 jobs. And worked grueling hours, you know, I started from the bottom with nothing, you know, and now I'm here, and Brendan Evans can testify to that. Yeah, indeed, on my way home. Another issue that I'll bring up is the reliability of individuals, you know, like, it can become quite, you know, a habit of somebody keeps doing it, it'll affect the whole team, bro, you know, so you gotta get rid of it. It's not as easy as saying, oh, okay, just go look for another worker, bro, you know. You can't really understand the full aspect of it until you go through it yourself, man. So I've decided, you know, just to work on my own. It's a lot easier and less stressful, man. Now, a lot of times over the last 2 years, you know, the only reason why work was still coming in, getting the workload, bro, because I was having to work Saturday and Sunday just to keep the workload coming in, bro, just to keep boys employed. You know, that shows you how hard I was working, bro. One of the simple things, bro. I'm not going to let some cunt treat me like a bitch, bro, I don't care who you are. You know, like, I'm at the same level as they are, bro, the big bosses as they are, bro. I'm at their level, bro. You know, they should never be treating me like a bitch, bro. They should fucking be respecting me, bro.